Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint the white and blue of the Shining Spears jet bikes. The first thing that we're going to need to do is to undercoat the model, and in this instance, we've used Corex White Spray. What this does is allow us to go straight into the first aspect of the video, which is to use apothecary white mixed in with contrast medium and then just applying that all over the model. So what we need to do is going to get 4 dollops of contrast medium onto our palette. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then just wash off the brush, and then just get 1 of apothecary white and mix that in. Just so you know, in this instance, I'm using a medium shade brush because this will allow me to apply it all over the model quite easily. Okay, so what I'm going to do is then just start moving that all over the model, making sure to keep the paint moving. And if it starts to pool anywhere, just make sure to dry off your brush and then just soak it up with the bristles. You're probably going to need to do 2 layers of this just to get into the recesses where we want it. And with that stage done, we've added all the depth to our white. The next thing that we need to do is to go into tidying it up. And for this, we're going to use Corex White all over the panels as a layer. And then we're going to use White Scar as an edge highlight. So what we need to do is get some Corex White onto our palette. There, and just a little bit more. And then get some water and thin it out. That's good. And I'm just going to wash off my brush, dry it out, because I just want to control how much I have on my brush. There we go, that's about right there. And what we're going to look to do is just run the Corex White over the uppermost areas of the panels as a layer, and then maintaining the apothecary white in the recesses. With the layer applied of Corex White, the next thing to do is to highlight up using White Scar. And just going to do this around all the edges of the jet bike, making sure to use the edge of your brush and just drag it along the edges to help you out. And with that edge highlight complete, the white areas of the jet bike are finished. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the blue areas of the jet bike. And for this, we'll be using Thousand Suns Blue. We're going to shade that using Dragonarf Nightshade, and then we're going to move into the edge highlights. For this, we're going to use Temple Guard Blue as our first edge highlight, and then Baharoth Blue as our second edge highlight. But the first thing that we need to do is get Thousand Suns Blue onto the palette. So what I'm going to do is get a couple of dollops here onto my palette. One more, and get some water and thin that out nicely. And just rolling my brush to a nice sharp point. Then what we're going to do is just start applying that all over this raised area here. Just need to get a little bit more onto my brush. And after we've done this raised area, we're then going to move on to doing the pennant or flag at the back. So with the blue now base coated, the next thing to do is to use Dragonarf Nightshade as a shade and then just shade over all the blue areas. Once it's dry, just go back over with Thousand Suns Blue just to pick out any areas that you want to and just clean up on the shade. And then I'm going to shade just into the recesses of the pennant and then go back over with Thousand Suns Blue just to tidy it up. Now that the Dragonarf Nightshade is dried, the next thing to do is to edge highlight using Temple Guard Blue. So I'm just going to run the edge of my brush, just the same as we did with the white, along the edges of the upper raised area. Just taking your time when doing this, just dragging the brush along the edge, and then just going around and doing it to all the blue areas. Now that that first stage of edge highlight on the blue is complete, we're going to move into doing the second stage, which is using Baharoth Blue and just running that along the uppermost edges of the blue. Just making sure that it is within the lines of the previous stage. And there we are, with that second edge highlight complete, the blue areas are finished. What we need to do now is to move into doing the nose design that you see on the box art. And for this, we're going to be using Thousand Suns Blue again, and we're going to use this to map out where we want that triangle to be. We're then going to fill in using Thousand Suns Blue and move into using Barrowhoth Blue as an edge highlight. So the first thing that we need to do is to get some Thousand Suns Blue onto our palette. So just there. And what I'm going to do is get some water and just thin it out. And what we're going to look to do here is just do some dots where we want the triangle to be on the front of the nose. So I'm going to do a dot as central as I can make it about here. There we go. So that's going to be how big it is. And then a dot towards the edge. So I know where it goes to. And then if I bring it to this side here, a dot down there. Next thing to do will be to fill it in. There we are, with the lines drawn, we filled in the area. The next thing we need to do is to edge highlight it using Barrowhoth Blue. I'm just going to run this along the edges. And there we are, with the edge highlight on the nose art done, the white and blue of the Shining Spears jet bike is complete. By following the techniques and methods you see in this video, you can easily transfer it to any other models that you may have in your Eldari collection, or any other models in your general collections that you have. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this painting video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Shining Spears, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye!